In this lecture, we will talk about the cell division and its different phases that occur in this cell cycle. In my last lecture, I discussed about the structure and function of chromosomes, the DNA and the different constituents that make up the DNA. Now, in this lecture, we will talk about the cell division. Now, cell division is of two types. It is mitosis and this is meiosis. In case of mitosis, one mother cell divides to give two daughter cells. So, the chromosome number is maintained. So, here in this case, chromosome number is maintained. So, if it is 2A in the mother cell, so it will give 2N to the daughter cell. Okay? Now, in this mitosis, the cell size remains the same in the daughter cell as that of the mother cell. This mitosis is mainly significant in growth, repair, replacement, and in some cases reproduction as well. But reproduction, meiosis mainly deals with the reproduction, that is the formation of the gametes or the haploid cells. Okay? So in mitosis, chromosome number is maintained in the daughter cell and the size of the cell is same as that of the mother. And this is helpful in the growth, repairment, replacement. In meiosis, this is the reproductive phase or the reproductive cycle. And it forms the sex cells, that is the gametes and the eggs. So, haploid number is 4 in number. Haploid number. Here, 2 in number. So this chromosome number is maintained in the mitosis, but in meiosis the chromosome number gets half. Okay, so and this helps in the formation of the gametes and the egg cells. Now we will talk about the mitosis. Now in mitosis, there in mitosis occurs in mitosis occurs in two phases. One is interphase . Another one is mitotic phase. Some people say that this is the resting stage of the cell, but this is not true, because in anaphase the cell prepares itself for the cell division, that is to enter into the mitotic phase. So mitotic phase can be again four phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Then we have cytokinesis, which is a part of this mitotic phase where cytoplasm divides. Okay? So, now this interphase is actually not the resting phase. Metabolic activities goes on in this phase, and this phase can be divided into three parts: growth phase 1 or G1 phase, synthetic phase or ACE phase, and growth phase 2, that is G2 phase. And there is another stage, that is G0, where the cell exits from the cell division. temporarily or permanently depending on the case. So when the cell division stops, when one cycle is over, so the cell exits the cell division, and that is, it is entering into the D0 stage. Okay, so this interphase is of three types: G1 phase. So this interphase is made up of G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. So if I draw a circle like this and divide its portion, so suppose this portion is the G1 phase, this portion is the S phase, this portion is the G2 phase, and from here till this is the mitotic phase, where you have prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase and cytokinesis. So this is the mitotic phase, or you can say karyokinesis and cytokinesis phase. And this part is the interphase. So in mitosis we have two phases, interphase and mitotic phase. Interphase is the preparatory phase for the cell to, so that it can provide all the enzymes or proteins for the cell division. So it prepares the cell for the cell division. So this is not the resting stage. Metabolic activities go on in this stage. Next, the cell enters into the mitotic phase, where the division of the cell starts, and that occurs under four stages. One is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. And lastly, the division of the cytoplasm takes place, and that is cytokinesis. So this is an overview of mitosis. Now, what happens in the interphase, or in the different phases of interphase, like in G2 phase, G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. First is G1 phase. In G1 phase, RNA, proteins, these are all synthesized, and certain enzymes are also synthesized for the next phase, because the next phase is actually the synthetic phase for the DNA. That means the DNA replicates in the next stage. So for the replication of DNA, there requires certain enzymes, certain proteins, which are made in the growth phase or the G1 phase. So here, in this case, RNA and certain proteins, enzymes are synthesized for the S phase. This overall interphase takes a much longer time than the mitotic phase. Okay, so in the G1 phase, it prepares the proteins, different proteins, enzymes for the next phase. Before moving into the S phase, suppose this is the G1 phase, this is the S phase, this is the G2 phase, and this is overall your mitotic phase. Okay. Now, G1, in the here, all proteins, enzymes, these are all synthesized for this S phase, where DNA replication will take place. Now, before entering into the S phase, there is a checkpoint, or there is a guard who is sitting and maintaining or guarding this phase, and observing whether all the proteins and enzymes which are required for the replication of DNA are prepared or not successfully. So this is a checkpoint. So this G1 has to give a signal that yes, I have synthesized all the necessary proteins and enzymes which are required for the DNA replication. So now I can enter into the S phase. So this checkpoint must be satisfied. and this checkpoint mainly is regulated by certain proteins like cyclin and cyclin dependent kinase. Okay, so this checkpoint is very sensitive, because it will not allow this G1 phase to enter into the S phase if it sees any problem or any flaws in the synthesis of these proteins and enzymes. Okay, so at this stage, if there is any problem in this phase, or if any proteins or enzymes are not synthesized in this phase, here there is an enzyme or a protein which halts or which helps in the stopping this stopping the cell in moving forward towards this mitotic division. Okay, so there is one protein which is sitting here and also guarding and halting this division if there is any problem in this phase. Okay, so there is the checkpoint. So if all the proteins are successfully synthesized, everything is okay in this phase, then only G1 can enter into the S phase. Okay, in the S phase, so next stage is the S phase. It is the synthetic phase where DNA replication occurs. So DNA number is getting doubled. At the same time, centrioles are also duplicated. They are also duplicated in this phase. So in this phase, these two are occurring. So you see, so DNA number is double. So from 2C, it is becoming 4C. Okay? Now, so it has achieved in the synthesis of or replication of DNA. Now it will enter into the G2 phase. In the G2 phase, proteins, enzymes, several RNAs are synthesized for the cell division. So this is another preparatory phase, and it is the shortest phase or interphase where certain proteins, enzymes are synthesized for the mitotic division. Okay, and there is another checkpoint here, and also here there was another checkpoint, G2S checkpoint. This was G1S checkpoint. This is G2S checkpoint. Again, it will halt the overall cell division if there is any flaws in this phase. Now there is another checkpoint here where it will again see whether all the enzymes or proteins are made or synthesized successfully or not, if any defects are there, any mutation has taken place or not. So here everything will be checked so that the cell division can occur smoothly, okay, without any errors. So these checkpoints help in the reduction of the error in the protein synthesis. So G2 phase is the phase where proteins are synthesized for the mitotic cycle, for the cell division. So this is your G1S and G2 phases of interphase. And there are certain checkpoints which are guarding the these points before entering into the each and every phase. Next, after G2, everything is done, all the proteins are synthesized successfully without any error. Now this will sing this checkpoint. If there the guard will signal, yes, you can now enter into the cell division and carry out the further process. So now the cell will enter into the mitotic phase. So you can see from the diagram, in the interphase, this was the nuclear membrane, and this nuclear membrane was intact, it should be in the normal case. And you can see these are the chromatin fibers, and this is the nuclear membrane. So the cell was same as it is before the mitotic phase. Now it is slowly entering into the second stage, that is the mitotic phase. In the mitotic phase, I told you there are four phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. In prophase, there is early prophase and late prophase. In overall prophase, the centrioles start condensing, and the condensed form is called the chromosome. So the chromatic fiber starts condensing or recoiling, packing itself to form the chromosome. Nuclear membrane will start disappearing slowly. Nucleolus will also start disappearing slowly. And the centrioles, which were duplicated in the interphase, will now slowly migrate towards the opposite pole. So this centrioles, which are composed of microtubules, they will slowly extend on the opposite pole and they will extend the spindle fiber. So you see, in the early prophase, what is happening? These two are the centrioles. You can see these are the asters. This is in the early prophase where the chromosome is condensing. So at this stage, still the nuclear membrane is intact in the early prophase. So again, we are doing the early prophase. So in the early prophase, what is happening? The chromatin fibers are condensing. Chromatin fibers are condensing and forming chromosome. So this is leading to the formation of chromosome. Okay? And you can see slowly the centrioles has started moving towards the opposite pole. One of the centrioles, one pair of the centrioles will move, other will be intact. Now, in the late prophase, what is happening? The nuclear membrane is slowly disappearing. This red color is the nuclear membrane, you can see, as shown you with the dotted lines. So you see, this is the nuclear membrane. If I redraw this here, so this is how the nuclear membrane is disappearing, and the condensed chromosome is highly coiling itself and becoming a highly dense and coiled chromosome, and two sister chromatids are formed. So in this case, what is happening? This is how the two sister chromatids are formed, and they are joined at the center, which we call centromere. So these are joined at the centromere. So you see how these thread-like structures, they have coiled and they have condensed together, and they are becoming this thicker chromosomes. They are forming chromosomes like this. So if I draw four chromosomes like this, so I'm just drawing the two. Okay, so you see how this highly dense and coiled chromosomes have formed. And you can see at the same time, one aster was there, two asters were there, and they were radiating. That is, these are made up of microtubules, which will form the spindle fibers when one of these centrioles will start moving and it will extend the spindle fiber. So slowly it will keep on extending around the pole till it reaches the antipodal position, just opposite to this one. So the position, it will move at 180 degree rotation. Okay, so one of the centrioles will start moving around the pole like this at 180 degree angle, and it will reach just the opposite pole. Same thing will happen from this side, and slowly this spindle fibers start forming, and they are getting attached at the centromere with the help of another region that is called kinetochore. So on the two sister chromatids, there is a formation of kinetochore through which this spindle fiber will be attached. So it's like this. Suppose this is the centromere, so this is the kinetochore, and to each of these kinetochore, the spindle fiber will be attached. Because in the later cases, these two will be separated. So unless and until the spindle fiber is attached on both the side of the sister chromatids, on opposite side, they cannot be separated. longitudinal. Okay, and you can see one more thing that how these chromosomes are slowly in the late prophase is coming here at the periphery of the nuclear membrane. Okay, now this was your prophase where the chromatin fibers were condensing and they were forming chromosome by coiling. Okay, so after vigorous coiling they are forming chromosomes. Okay, next the nuclear, and they are moving towards the periphery of the nuclear membrane, and thus the nuclear membrane is disappearing. Two centrioles that were formed, that were duplicated in the interphase, they are, one of them are starting to move to the opposite pole at an angle of 180 degrees, and along with them they are extending the spindle fiber, and these are getting attached at the sister chromatids. So this was your first stage of cell division. Now next is the, it is entering into the metaphase, and in metaphase whole of this dotted nuclear membrane that I've drawn, this has disappeared completely. So in metaphase you can see there is no nuclear membrane at all, and you can see how these chromosomes, they have aligned themselves at the equator. So the chromosomes aligned themselves at the equator with the help of this spindle fiber, equatorial region, and they are attached by the spindle fiber at the kinetochore on the both sides of the sister chromatids. So this is your metaphase. So we can say these are metaphase play. Okay, so you can see these which were like thoroughly like randomly and thoroughly spread throughout the nucleus, slowly they are rearranging themselves, and slowly how they are coming at the equator. So they must lie at the center, like at the equator. This is how they must lie at the equator. Okay, so that they can be splitted easy. Okay, so this is what is happening in the metaphase. In my next lecture we will talk about the other phases of mitosis.